morning students, today I will continue the science chapter 4, sorting materials into groups. Okay, in the previous class only we have started the two sessions on this lesson itself. In that we have learned about the importance of classification materials and also the which are some of the properties of the materials. That is, first one is the appearance. Properties of materials also we have learned, that is appearance, texture, hardness and soluble or insoluble. Okay, in that soluble or insoluble, solubility of solids in water, solubility of liquids in water and solubility of gases in water. Okay, up to here we have completed. Next, go for the fifth state, that is state. Fifth property is state. Most of the materials are grouped on the basis of their physical state into a solid, liquid or gases. The main difference between these three states are given in table 4.2. Okay, most of the materials are grouped in the three basis, that is physical state into a solid, liquid and also in the gaseous state. Okay, now below that they have given the table differences in solid, liquid and gaseous. Okay, first is parameter. Okay, solids, liquids and gaseous. Okay, in the shape, if we have taken shapes in the solids, the shape of the solids is definite, means particular shape will found in the solids, and also in liquid, not defined. Okay, not definite shape. Okay, example, you take it as a dal, curry. Okay, it have any particular shape for that? No. Okay, if you put any dal or else any curries in a bowl, it will take the shape of that bowl. Means it is a liquid state. Okay, water, example. If you have any definite shape for the water? No, we don't have any definite shape for the water. If you pour that in the bottle, it will take the shape of the bottle. If you pour that in the glass, then it will take the shape of the glasses. Next is gas. Gas also does not have any definite shape, volume. Okay, the volume of a solid is fixed. Liquid also has a particular volume. Gas, it does not have any particular value. Next, compressibility. Cannot be compressed. Okay, can be compressed to a small extent. Highly compressible. The gas can be highly compressible. Packing, particles are closely packed. Okay, the particles which are present in the solids, they are packed very tightly. Particles are less closely packed in the comparison or when you compare to the solids. Okay, when you compare to the solids and the liquids, in liquid the particles in the liquid is not closely packed like the solids. Particles are very loosely packed in gases. Okay, this is about the state. Next, come to the floating and sinking. Take a coin and a leaf. Okay, you have to check in your home this one. You have to take one leaf and also the one coin. Put them in a beaker, half filled with water. You have to take one beaker and you have to fill water off for that. And you have to drop both the leaf and the coin inside the water. You observe that the coin sinks in the water while the leaf floats on it. Okay, you have observed that the coin will drop directly to the bottom of the beaker, but the leaf will float on the water. Coin is heavier than the water. Why? Because if the coin is very heavy, then the volume of the water is less than the coin. That is why it sinks in water. Leaf, being lighter than water, floats on it. Okay, the leaf is very lighter when you compare to the volume of a water. So it flows on the water, floating and sinking. Next is transparency. transparency. Seventh property is transparency. Hold a glass tumbler in front of your eyes. See through it. You can see all object through it. Okay. When you have taken the glass beaker, anything, if you put anything inside that, you can see the complete what the things are in the glass tumbler. The material through which we can see the objects clearly are called transparent materials. Okay. If you put anything also, you can see it clearly. They are called what? Transparent materials. And this property material is called what? Transparency. Glass is a transparent material. And some other examples of transparent materials are water, alcohol, hair, and cell phone paper. Some kind of plastic bottles are also transparent. Okay, some of the examples for the transparent are glasses. Okay, and also the water, alcohol, hair, and the cell phone paper. We put the SIM card or the screen card on the phones, no? That is also a cell phone paper. And some kind of the plastic bottles also a transparent. Hold a cardboard in front of your eyes. You can see through it. Example, you think it is the cardboard. If you put anything in front of you, you can see the what is behind the cardboard here? No, we can't see. So it is not a transparent material. The material through which we cannot see the objects are called opaque materials. Okay, the materials through which we can see the objects clearly is called transparent materials. Then the materials through which we cannot see the objects are called what? Opaque materials. And this property of material is called what? Opaqueness. Metals, books, and wood are some examples of opaque materials. Some of the examples for opaque materials are, you can take is a cardboard, door, material. Which are the things that we can't see the materials? That is called what? Opaque materials. We keep our things in closed iron almirah so they cannot be seen. So that purpose only, we keep some of the items, gold things, and everything in the almirahs and cupboards so no one can see them. Shopkeepers usually prefer to keep biscuits, sweets, and other eatables in the transparent glass jars and transparent plastic containers so that buyer can easily see these items. Okay, when you went to the shops or when you went to the bakeries, you can see that they have kept everything in the transparent glass cupboards, or else they will keep in the transparent glass jars or also plastic jars. Means to buy, we can see the materials which are present in them very easily for the buying. You can see some of the chocolate biscuits, they will keep in the transparent glasses itself. Hold a butter paper in front of your eyes. You can see partially through it. The material through which we can see the objects partially are called what? Transparent materials. Example, you have to take a butter paper. Okay. Some of the cardboard sheet. You can say here. Okay, you can see this wrapper. Okay, we have this wrapper now. This wrapper is what? Transparent paper. Transparent materials means we can't see them completely clearly, but we can see something. Okay, that is called what? Transparent materials. And this property of materials for transparency. Butter paper is a transparent material. Grounded glass, frosted glass, tissue paper, dust ladder, air, fog and mist are other transparent materials. Okay, these are the examples of transparent materials. This completes your lesson 4th lesson, sorting materials into groups. Okay, in that they have given the correct answers. I will say now, it will take in the textbook. Grounded glasses is an ash material. Soft, opaque, transparent or transparent. Grounded glasses is the transparent material. So you have to tick for the C option. First one is C option. Which of the following is soluble in water? Which can dissolve in water? Sand, plastic, common salt, or chalk powder? Okay, common salt is dissolvable in water. Which of the following insoluble in water, means it is which won't mix with the water, glycerin, vinegar, kerosene or alcohol. Okay, third one is the kerosene. Kerosene is answer for that. Kerosene won't mix with the water, but glycerin, vinegar and alcohol, they will mix with the water. Which of the following does not float on water? Which will won't float on water? Stone, feather, paper, coconut oil. Okay, on water the stone will be won't float on the water because the volume of the stone is more than the water, so it will sink to the ground. Answer is stone. Which is made up of metal? Book, eraser, pencil or necklace? Okay, necklace is a made up of a metal called gold. So necklace is a metal. So tick for the D option. Fifth one is D option. The special kind of a shine present on the material is called what? The special kind of shine present on material is called what? Luster. Okay, first fill in the blanks is what? Luster. L-U-S-T-S-T-R-E. Okay, the special kind of a shine present on the material is called what? Luster. Dash metals have no bumps or ridges on and have a plain surface. What they are called? They are called smooth materials. Second one is smooth materials. And third one, what they have given? Iron is a dash metal. Iron is what material? That is a, it is a hot material. Next, vinegar is dash in water, soluble. Vinegar is soluble in water. The coin is heavier than water, so it will dash in water. So it will sink in water. Material that cannot be compressed or called what? Or called material that can be hard materials. That cannot be compressed or called what? Hard materials. Okay, students, got it? This is filling the blanks. Next, match the following. They have given column A and column B. Glycerin, gold, glass, food, metal wax. Metal wax. Okay. In that, what? Glycerin. Okay. It is a miscible in water. Means it can be mixed with the water. Glycerin matched to the miscible in water. Next, gold. Gold is a, it has a shiny surface. No, that is called what? Gold is a luster. So, match with the lusters. Gold is a luster materials. And melted wax is a soft material. okay, would you match to the rough material? Melted wax you match to the soft material. Okay, B column answers, I will say the numbers, you match that one. 3, 4, 5, 1 and 2. 3, 4, 5, 1 and 2. Okay, these are the numbers for the match the following. Got it, students? If you have any doubts regarding this, you can call me, students. Thank you.